Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. I hate to disappoint you, but no Benjamin Franklin nonsense tonight. We do have what I think is a really great program planned for you. And it's my pleasure to kick it off by introducing a friend of mine and my boss. And you all know him from IAC. There are many other people know him from Jeopardy, where he's one of the top individual winners and was on the All-Star team, championship team. But for each of us, he's the incredibly creative person who brought us all together and who designed most of these wonderful competitions you've been involved in. So my great pleasure to introduce you to Mr. David Madden.
Thanks, Jay. Good evening. Oh, you can do better than that. Good evening. There we go. All right. So, wow, what a week. Welcome to the closing ceremonies of the 2022 International History Olympiad. Give yourselves a big hand for all you've achieved over the last 7 days. We're delighted to celebrate your accomplishments this evening on board the USS Intrepid. What a venue, so historic, here in the heart of New York City. My name is David Madden. As Jay mentioned, I'm the founder and executive director of International Academic Competitions, the parent organization of the International History Olympiad. And it's my great honor to have you all here with me this evening as we have one last gala evening of events and medals and lots more to come. My wife, Nolwenn, and I, and give her a hand, she's done a tremendous amount of work to make this weekend week happen as well. She and I founded the Olympiad together in 2015 as a chance for the world's top history students to come together to test their skills in a week of exciting and diverse competitions while getting the chance to make friends from around the world who have mutual interests in history. We've seen that you've had a great time doing just that over the last week, and we hope that you will enjoy the conclusion of the Olympiad tonight. I have just a few brief logistical announcements, and then we'll get right into the first awards of the evening. And we will then have a great presentation throughout. First, however, I have this announcement that there is a tie that needs to be broken. I will not say what place it is for, but it is in the overall Olympiad rankings within the division. We need a clear top 10, and we need a specific student to fill out each of those top 10 spots. So if I can ask Sahil Prasad of Maryland and Evan Ting of Indiana to give them a hand. That means they're in the top 10. If I can ask, we'll find out exactly where they are. Okay, hello, gentlemen. So if you can just proceed over towards the entry, Jay will take you down, or Arthur will take you down, and we will get you set with your tie break in short order. Apologies for any hydration issues earlier in the evening. We have since rectified that. There's plenty of water over there on the tables if you need it. There are also water spouts available on the ship if you have your IAC commemorative water bottle that we've given you for the Olympiad, and we hope you've been using throughout the week. This program will run tonight until about somewhere in the neighborhood of 9:15, 9:30. Around 10 o'clock, we'll start disembarking the ship to head back to Princeton for one last night. Those of you who competed in the New York City history exam this morning, your awards will be done and given to you back at the hotel, as there were still a few things that needed to be sorted out with that. That having been said, though, it's my honor to bring about the first medals of the evening. And these will be the Aerospace History Medal Ceremony. This took place just a few minutes ago on the ship, and we will have our first medalists coming up in short order. So, we tested your knowledge of everything aviation related, and we had the finals of this competition on such a unique spot on the flight deck of the USS Intrepid, site of so much history itself. But we will now be calling up those students who have medaled in that event. These are the last of the buzzer competitions that took place over the course of this week. So I'd like to begin with the elementary division, and the bronze medal in the Aerospace History Bee goes to Elliott Park of Virginia. Angelica could come up and assist with the medals as well. Give her a big hand for all of her support of the Olympiad throughout the week. Podium. The silver in the elementary division goes to Leo Lewis, representing the state of New York. And the gold goes to Satvik Jain of Maryland. Flags will be saying where they are tonight, but you will have the opportunity to take photos with them later. Okay, congratulations to our elementary medalists in the Aerospace History Bee. And next for the middle school division. The bronze medal going all the way down under to Australia with Angus Patterson taking honors. The silver going to Parker Jelke of Florida. And the gold medal going to Cooper Mears of Tennessee. If you can.
Sweet eyes, soda pop, I still dream about that.
Rocky
Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee.
Rocky Top, Tennessee. All right, congratulations to our middle school division medalists. Next, the junior varsity, the bronze, going to Jaden Cho of South Korea.
The silver going to Aaron Parsa of California.
Wow, looking dapper. How'd that happen?
And the gold to Abhivir Arvindayar, also of California. Congratulations to our JV medalists, and that leaves just varsity, not last but certainly not least, with the bronze in the varsity going to Aditya Maduri from Tennessee. The silver goes to Lucas Fitz-Chapman of New Jersey. There we go. And the gold to Cooper Rowe of Illinois. Congratulations to our Varsity Aerospace History B medalists. I'm your boy. Okay, as the Varsity medalists take their seats for the Aerospace History B, a few other words I would like to share with all of you. First off, it's been at times a hectic, busy, frustrating, invigorating, exhilarating week, whatever you want to call it, but it wouldn't have been possible without all the support of the parents and teachers and coaches who got you here. Give them a big hand for all of their work and their support. And next, if you could join me in a standing ovation for all of your awesome International History Olympiad staff. Give them a great hand for all of their hard work over the course of the week. Staff. All right. So not only do we have an amazing staff corps, but we have several special guests joining us tonight, representing organizations that International Academic Competitions has partnered with. Jeremy Dublin is joining us tonight to represent the Rainforest Alliance. The Rainforest Alliance is one of the world's leading conservation organizations and does amazing work at the forefront of conservation, biodiversity, sustainable agriculture, and the fight against global climate change. As of this past April, I am delighted to be serving as an official Rainforest Alliance ambassador with a specific focus on developing environmental education programs. IAC, and in particular our in-country team in Ecuador, looks forward next summer to launching the International Environmental Science Olympiad with the support of the Rainforest Alliance. We look forward to bringing you all, or those who qualified and are interested, next summer to Quito, the Amazon, and the Galapagos. So give the Rainforest Alliance a hand for their support of IAC and working together with us to make that happen. Additionally, Jonathan Gross is joining us tonight to represent AFS USA, the world's oldest organization devoted to international high school student exchange. I had the privilege of being an AFS exchange student myself in Vienna, Austria, back in 1998-1999, a long time ago. And my family also hosted a girl from Indonesia who was herself an exchange student to the USA in 2008. I encourage all families to consider hosting an AFS or any other exchange student from around the world as a great way to build bridges and international friendships. I also encourage all families and all students to consider being an exchange student themselves. For me, the 6 months that I spent as an AFSer in Vienna, Austria, were the 6 most influential, formative, and amazing months of my life. So if you see Jonathan or Jeremy tonight, please have a conversation with them about the work they're doing with Rainforest Alliance and with AFS. So give AFS a big hand for their support of IAC as well. So the next item on our program is a special treat courtesy of our videography team from AV Adventures. Adam Stackhouse and Liz have been working all week long to produce great coverage of our events, and I'd like now for you to have a look at the At the Buzzer segment that they have put together. So welcome, AV Adventures, Liz Sykes, Adam Stackhouse. Here is what you put together at the buzzer.
So excited to be here at the International History Olympiad in Princeton, New Jersey and New York City. We've got so many great events, a lot of great buzzer competitions, of course, but beyond that, field trips, simulations, task forces, a lot of great events for those who are really competitive and those who also want to get to know their fellow students from all around the world.
International academic competitions stemmed from a tournament I ran for fun, the Tri-State History Bowl at Ridgewood High School, just up the Garden State Parkway. That was on May 22nd, 2010. We had 135 students from around the New York City area come in and compete. And it literally took me about 10 minutes of doing that to realize how, not only how much fun it was, but how rewarding it was and how important the work is of transmitting historical knowledge from generation to generation. And now we have had tournaments on all 6 populated continents.
So at the International History Olympiad, students take part in a wide variety of events to test their knowledge of history. All students participate in the International History B World Championships as individuals and the International History Bowl World Championships on teams. And we ask students to demonstrate their knowledge of everything from ancient history all the way up to recent history. Students can also elect to take part in buzzer-based competitions focusing on specialized areas of history, including science, technology, engineering, and math, classical music, pop music, art history, everything you can imagine.
So my favorite part of participating is meeting all my fellow students and competing with them. It's really fun, especially competing with my friends. It's kind of like a rivalry. It makes all the games more fun and a little bit more stressful in a way.
I love history too. I would not say I'm anywhere near as good as he is, but I do enjoy sitting in and listening to some of the competitions and some of the questions. I also talk to other parents and we talk about how this whole competition and how the whole IAC program is affecting and helping their kids, and it's amazing how they've thought through this.
The fact that I'm able to, this gives me the opportunity to meet others who have similar passions of mine really drives me to just take that long trip just to get here.
So in addition to the buzzer-based activities, we have task forces and simulations. The task forces are basically getting the kids together after preparing some research material to think about global events, global topics of utmost relevance. The simulations are very similar to Model United Nations, and I think the goal is to basically get them to, you know, step out of their own lives and put themselves in the shoes of someone else, whether it's the United Nations Security Council, the Indian Cabinet, or even the Council of Alexander the Great.
So I've really loved not only the academic competitions, but also meeting lots of people from all over the world. And I think that's really enriched my experiences and meeting people from lots of different cultures, not just hearing the question or seeing the question and writing it, and but also talking to other people about it and getting their perspective on an issue. I think that's really helped in my understanding and learning of a topic or a concept.
Studies are not just sitting there with a book. Like, learning is a fun activity. And in our house, we try to make learning fun. Like, you know, our motto is not for school, but for life we learn. And I think that's one of the great parts, because you get to use that learning for fun and for games here.
So in addition to the academic competitions, IAC provides these cultural experiences for its participants. We take the kids to museums, to public parks, and they get to see works of art. They get to meet our international staff and our international partners. They get to meet each other from all over the world. It brings what is one event into a truly international experience.
We really went around the city. We walked, which was like really fun because you could actually see them in person. Saw Wall Street, we got to see the 9/11 Memorial and Freedom Tower.
I really like how they have organized it really well. For parents, they are not letting them get bored. For them, they have organized field trips, which is really good. And the most important thing is they are showing the history and culture of USA, which is really good.
So when I went on the Princeton tour, and that it was a very beautiful experience. David Madden, the owner, the creator of the History Bee and this Olympia, he was a Princeton alumni, so he gave us a very detailed tour. And he even hinted that he might give us a recommendation letter if we asked him, which is pretty nice. But yeah, that's definitely the Princeton tour is my favorite.
We end each day with a medal ceremony where we recognize the winners from that day's events. It's a great opportunity for students to wave their flag and hear their state songs and national anthems. It's also a great time for everyone to come together and appreciate the level of competition that we have here at this tournament.
I'm really happy that the guest of honor during the 2022 International History Olympiad is Polish Princess Angelika Jarosławska-Sapieha. The history of her family dates back to, well, our rich Polish history. So having her speak in front of the participants yesterday, I think that it's also a very inspiring opportunity for those kids.
I believe that you not only have royal minds, but also royal hearts. And each of you is a change maker. You're in the United States, you came from different part of the globe because you have great motivation to do something special in your life. So today I want to tell you about things which can be fixed, which can be changed by you, because you are the power that can change the world and that can save the lives today and tomorrow.
One of the things that's happening this week is the Polish country exam, which is a written exam with questions about Poland. And the winner of the competition will be announced during the closing ceremony, and that winner receives a full paid trip to Poland.
We have two kids who were the champions of our History Bee at our nationals in May in Warsaw. So that's really great to see the representation of our country at an international competition.
I'm very delighted that during the last days you heard so much about Polish culture, history and heritage. I want to inspire you to see that the Polish saber is much more than just an item. It's Polish heritage, it's Polish culture and Polish soul.
We're wrapping things up with our closing ceremony and final competitions at the Intrepid Sea, Air, and Space Museum along the Hudson River. It's such an exciting way to honor our participants and have a final ceremony to bring everyone together. and cap off the International History Olympiad.
Thank you so much to Adam and Liz and AV Adventure for putting that together for us. Okay, so still a lot to get through. So without any further ado, we're going to continue on with our medal ceremony here. And the next program up on the agenda is for the International History Bee World Championships. So this took place a little bit earlier this week, and we had said that we would save the finalists to be recognized and save the medalists to be recognized on board the USS Intrepid. We have plaques available here as well, not just medals, as we are recognizing the top six in each age division. So we will begin with the elementary division, and in sixth place is Imandeep Mataru from California. In fifth place from Indiana is Gavin Sigwa. Congratulations. In fourth place from Maryland, Satvik Jain. In third place, from representing the United Kingdom, Adrit Satyamangalam. We have plaques for our International History Bee top finisher. In second place, representing Maryland, Sahil Prasad. He may still be busy with the tiebreak. And the gold, or the champion plaque, going to Quentin Cunningham, representing New Jersey. Congratulations to all of our elementary finalists in the International History Bee. Moving into the middle school division. Sixth place goes to Grant Hahn from California. Place goes to Houghton Neffel from Virginia. Fourth place goes to Alan Marek, representing Georgia, the U.S. state. In the middle school division goes to Padraig Finan from Washington State. Second place goes to Sumanya Ganesh from the U.S. state of Georgia. And first place, all the way from Singapore, congratulations to Luke Ng. In the junior varsity division, sixth place in the International History B World Championships goes to Thomas Glotfelty of Virginia. Fifth place goes to Lucas O'Flanagan from Connecticut. Fourth place goes to Ethan Liu from Massachusetts. Third place goes to Abhivir Arvind Iyer from California. Second place goes to Aaron Parsa of California. And first place going across the Hudson River to New Jersey, Robert Wong. In the varsity, a match that I had the pleasure of reading myself, sixth place goes to Simon Emmanuel from New Jersey. Fifth place goes to Raymond Haw from Canada. Fourth place goes to Ian Liu of New York. New York City, nonetheless, where you are tonight. Third place goes to Tanuj Chandakar of New Jersey. Second place goes to Yanni Batayola Ranolo from the Philippines. And the varsity world champion in the International History B, Cooper Rowe from Illinois. Told me he has a few words to say, so give it up for Cooper, your world champion, the varsity.
Hi, everyone. I can't see a thing right now. The projector's right in my eyes, but I'm Cooper. I've graduated. I'll be heading to Columbia after a gap year, and originally from the state of Illinois, and I'm just up here to say a couple words. Number one, my family is here. My sister has been recording a docu-series on Quiz Bowl trying to spread the word. Audrey, I love you. Thank you so much. And to my two amazing parents, they have been supporting me ever since I was in third grade when I first started this shindig. And I have nothing more to say than thank you for doing everything and more to support me and keep me happy, as good parents should. Thank you, guys. I love you. And I guess as my very quick last note to my fellow competitors, from the varsity to the elementary and the future competitors, I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. And I, on that note, a couple of parents have been asking me how I've studied, how I've done so well in this, and and I like to tell them the same thing, which is to keep an open mind. You're not here to pretend that you know everything. You're here to learn. It is so much fun. I was so much fun in the final when like 15 questions went dead. And I was like, that is someone I've never heard of and I will go and Google right after this is over. And that was the highlight of my experience here. To know that I know nothing, essentially. It is truly humbling. So on that note, to my fellow competitors, young and old, stay humble, stay kind, stay curious, and your work will speak for you. Thank you.
Thanks, Cooper. Cooper Rowe, ladies and gentlemen, one of the most successful students in academic competition history, and your world champion in the International History Bee
varsity division this week. We are joined by a number of dignitaries tonight representing Polish-American friendship organizations and organizations that are working to build bridges between our two countries. I would like to give them a hand and a warm welcome on behalf of the International History Olympiad. And as you know, throughout the week, we have been delighted to be joined by Princess Angelika Jarosławska-Sapieha, a humanitarian champion who has been doing incredible work on behalf of numerous causes, including acting as a UN peace ambassador, helping to organize the Veterans Memory Rally in the USA, being the founder of the One Mine, One Life Anti-Landmine Initiative, and serving as an ambassador for the International Network of Women Entrepreneurs. What you may not know is that Princess Angelika is also the ambassador of Squadron 303. She's also the ambassador of the 303 Museum, the president of the Foundation of Polish Pilots Fighting in Poland and Abroad, and she's responsible for the global international promotion of the movie Squadron 303 and its international premieres. Give her a big hand. The movie Squadron 303 tells the story of the Polish pilots in the Battle of Britain who collectively became the most effective unit in combat against the Luftwaffe at one of the most critical moments in all of human history. Winston Churchill famously said in regards to the Allied fighter pilots of the Battle of Britain that never before in the field of human conflict has so much been owed by so many to so few. That is not only so true, but even among the pilots themselves, more is owed to the Polish aviators of Squadron 303 than to any other unit. They faced initial prejudice to even be allowed to take part in the fight against the Luftwaffe, but overcoming both that and German Air Force, they wrote one of the greatest chapters, not only in Polish history, but in world history too. We are going to now show a trailer for the movie Squadron 303, and I encourage you to watch the movie at your leisure when you get a chance. So I would like to bring up Princess Angelika to the stage, give her a warm welcome, as we then show the trailer for Squadron 303.
Force is keeping Britain's feet dry.
Yes, but for how long?
Unless we use the 8,000 Polish airmen we have at our disposal.
When will all these training exercises stop so that we can get into the real action?
You're not ready.
What am I supposed to tell my pilots who don't know whether your families are alive or dead?
Then what happens to the Poles? They all die. And you don't care.
Buy us time until the Americans enter the war.
Here is the only piece, the last piece of our free Poland. We are here! We are Polish Army! And we will continue our fight as long as we draw breath. Give those bloody Germans hell!
Is that clear?
Yes, sir!
And they are really doing it.
You can call me Johnny.
You can go now.
You saved my life. You are the bloody best pilot we've got.
Squadron 303!
Yeah! You will not find better pilots on this earth, sir.
You don't have to fight anymore.
But I want to fight. May I ask you to dance with me?
I would love to dance with you. You can't survive this war.
This is my life. And I don't want to abandon my brothers. I have to fight.
Eyes like fire.
Dear friends. Dear friends. It is a special moment for all the Poles around the world. Tomorrow we commemorate the Warsaw Uprising, which was the single largest military effort taken by any European resistance movement during the World War II. On August 2nd, we commemorate the legendary 303 Squadron, which was formed on that day, 82 years ago. So it is really a special time for us, Poles. Today we gathered together on the historic USS Intrepid, an American aircraft carrier that served for the US Navy and the American pilots during the Second World War. Today I want to speak not only about the war and its terrible effects, but first and foremost, I want to speak about peace. Peace education is very important, and the greatest importance is maintaining peace, especially today when the inhuman, cruel war is taking place in Ukraine. Thousands of Ukrainians lost their lives already. Millions were forced to flee to other countries to make their children safe. Infrastructure and cultural heritage are destroyed in many places. Access to the hospitals is extremely limited. Since World War II, there were many conflicts around the globe. Millions of people, children, adults, elderly, had sought refuge in remote corners of the world. It is very hard to start all over again. For me, as an international peace ambassador and global anti-landmine activist, it is extremely important to speak about the terrible effects of war. It was said today already, but I will repeat. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. Those were the words of Winston Churchill about the pilots who fought in the Battle of Britain. Among the few were the young men of the Polish Air Force, whose bravery and education played a vital role in defeating the Luftwaffe. Number 303 Squadron RAF was also known as the 303rd Tadeusz Kościuszko Warsaw Fighting Squadron, and was one of the two Polish squadrons to fight during the Battle of Britain. In total, there were 16 Polish squadrons in RAF. 303 Squadron was the most successful fighter command unit in the Battle of Britain. Those young pilots were fighting not only for Poland or Great Britain, not even for Europe. They were fighting for the whole world, as Nazism was spreading very quickly and brought a death toll. The story about the 303 Squadron is a story about persistence, bravery, and standing for what is right. The story motivated many people around the world to become a better person, to stand for what they believe is important. That was our goal and our purpose, to bring this story again to life, to show the story for the international publicity. Motivated by beautiful passion for aviation, these pilots, well-educated young pilots, started the hardest exam in their lives. In making the 303 Squadron movie, I had the honor to meet pilots from the 303 Squadron and other squadrons who fought in the Battle of Britain. Today I can say that we were racing against the ticking clock. A few years ago, the Veterans Rally took place in the United States, which was co-organized by my foundation. The rally covered over 6,000 kilometers from Los Angeles to New York, with 44 stops on the way to commemorate the Polish soldiers who died in Afghanistan, but also to raise awareness about the PTSD syndrome, another burden of war. During that time, I visited here in New York, Jerzy Głuszewski in his apartment. He was a soldier of the Independent Carpathian Brigade and later a pilot of the 308 Fighter Squadron. We became friends and we exchanged many, many letters. He was a wonderful Pole, but also wonderful American. I remember a small tear in his eyes when we watched together for the first time the 303 Squadron movie. That was a great motivation to do everything what was in our power to promote this history, to teach the young generation about their bravery. I have a vivid memory of his words, which I want to tell you today. War is the worst thing on earth. There is nothing beautiful in the war. The most beautiful thing on earth is peace, which enables young people like yourself to dream and create their future, to educate and to build. It is our human duty to create and improve the future for the next generations. When Jerzy Głuszewski was a young man, his dream was to become an architect. The war destroyed his plans, but after the war, he was persistent enough to fulfill his dream. Jerzy Głuszewski in the USA worked for the UN and Ford Foundation. He also lectured in architecture at the Pratt Institute in New York. But before that fact, he was an architect in post-war Warsaw. After the war, as an architect, he worked in a team that rebuilt the most valuable architectural monuments in Warsaw, modeled on Canaletto's paintings. Today, when I walk in a Central Park near to his apartment, my heart is fulfilled with the gratitude. Tomorrow, my dear friends, is the Warsaw Uprising anniversary. After the 5 years of Nazi terror, a group of 23,000, mainly very young people, started to fight in Warsaw. Only 10% of them were armed. Traces of the uprising's terrible fights have remained in Warsaw till today. Before the war, Warsaw was called the Paris of the North. Today you will see the fragments of the Squadron 303 movie, here in New York, but also in LA, in Chicago, with the producers and actors. We had many meetings in theaters with people from all over the world who wanted to listen about the legendary 303 Squadron. I also highly encourage you to visit 303 Museum in Poland, in Napoleon, which has the largest collection of the memorabilia of Polish pilots from the Battle of Britain, which I have the honor to be an ambassador. I would like to thank the organizer of the International History Olympiad, David Madden. It is my honor to give you, David, a medal, a special coin founded by my foundation for the remembrance of the Polish pilots fighting in Poland and abroad. This medal is a symbol of the gallantry of the 303 Squadron, but also a great reminder of Tadeusz Kościuszko traditions, who is a hero both in Poland and here in the United States. Thank you, David, for teaching the youngest that education is the key. Access to education is a human right, but also a great blessing, of which many children around the world are deprived due to the wars and poverty. Dear laureates, during the Olympiad, you learn about history, geography, and culture. Education will enable you to become responsible adults. I truly believe in that. It will allow you to live peacefully with a deep understanding of the world and also with great respect for other people, other cultures, other religions. It will teach you to solve the problems and to solve the global conflicts. I believe in you, as well as our grandfathers who fought for freedom. Chwała bohaterom. God bless America. It is the moment when I want to give David Madden the symbol of the 303 Squadron. It's the symbol of Kościuszko Division as well, and Tadeusz Kościuszko. So that is why the 303 Squadron has its nickname, Tadeusz Kościuszko Warsaw Fighting Squadron.
Bardzo dziękuję.
Bardzo proszę.
Thank you so much, Princess Angelica. What a phenomenal honor. I am truly humbled to receive this. I would like, in the spirit of this honor, to announce a couple of initiatives that will both be named in honor of Tadeusz Kościuszko, a great Polish patriot and American patriot that IAC has the pleasure and the honor to bring into fruition over the next few years. The first is a little history lesson. This is perhaps the last history lesson of the week for many of you. But Tadeusz Kościuszko spent quite a bit of time in the United States during the Revolution. He was a military engineer, and he was responsible for building the fortifications at Bemis Heights that enabled the victory at Saratoga, one of the most essential in the American Revolution. He then fought with distinction in the Southern campaigns, paving the way for the victory at Yorktown. The United States as a nation has much to thank him. Tadeusz Kościuszko was assisted throughout this campaign by an African-American who was his orderly, and Kościuszko developed a great friendship with the African-American people. Kościuszko, before he left the USA for the last time, left a will that stipulated that his American estate should go to the funding for the manumission and education of African-American slaves and their children. Kościuszko died several decades later, and due to some confusion and the reluctance of a number of his American executors to follow through with that, the funds were never put to their proper purpose. IAC is thus delighted to announce the foundation of the Tadeusz Kościuszko Legacy Scholarship, which will provide education for several African-American students each year to study as exchange students in Poland. We are committing ourselves to funding this and look forward to working with organizations promoting Polish-American friendship to bring that about. Secondly, the story of Squadron 303 and the legacy of Tadeusz Kościuszko are reflections of the great contributions that Poland has made to American history and world history. Poland, however, is at a bit of a disadvantage in that its language is not commonly taught in American schools, unlike, say, French, Spanish, German, Chinese, or others. Throughout this week, we have featured IAC Polska as the centerpiece of a number of our events, including the country exam, for which we will soon announce the medalists. The country exam was a 100-question multiple-choice exam all about the culture and history of Poland. The top student overall, who is not from Poland, no, I mean by that who, excepting the two Polish students who are here, for everybody else, the top finisher, wins a free trip to Poland as a cultural ambassador. And IAC is funding that trip, and we look forward to working with the student and their family for an incredible experience. That having been said, that is just an event for the International History Olympiad in 2022. But we want to make this permanent, and thus we are founding the Tadeusz Kościuszko Prize that will make this an annual competition for students in the USA, with the top student each year on an exam of Polish culture and history winning a free trip to Poland. And we are delighted to make that then one of our competitions going forward. With that in mind, I would like to proceed with our next medal ceremony, which in fact will be the country exam. So, as I said, the top students in this exam are not only winning medals, but those who win gold, I would like to invite to stay on upstage. And then we will announce who has won the trip. I will say that the top overall score on the exam did go to Krzysztof Piotrowski, one of the two Polish students who is attending the Olympiad. Congratulations to Krzysztof. Krzysztof already, by dint of his performance in the International History Bees Polish National Championships, won a trip to the Olympiad, so he's already got his travel back to Poland covered. But we will see who among everybody else has the honor to join him, at least at some point later this year. So we will begin with the elementary division in the country exam, which focused on Poland. And the bronze medal goes to Adrith Satyamangalam Sarvesh from the United Kingdom. Continuing the legacy of Squadron 303 in Polish-British relations. And we have some special gifts courtesy of our IEC Polska team to offer to our country exam medalists as well. The silver in the elementary division goes to Henry Berger of Maryland. And the gold in the elementary division goes to Krzysztof Piotrowski of Poland. And continuing on then to the middle school division in the country exam, focusing on Poland, with the bronze medal going to Gil Pedrotti from Louisiana. The silver going to Samanyu Kanesh from the U.S. state of Georgia. And the gold medal, and in contention for the trip to Poland, congratulations to Luke Ng of Singapore. Congratulations! Moving into the junior varsity division, the bronze goes to Lucas O'Flanagan of Connecticut. Silver goes to Daniel Demel from Poland. And winning gold, and thus in contention for the trip, gold goes to Texas, Sean Pastelaniec. Congratulations! Sean in contention for the trip. And that leaves the varsity division with the bronze going to Raymond Ha from Canada. The silver goes to Ian Liu from New York. And the gold medal to Catherine Spusta from Alabama in contention for the trip. Congratulations! So if Catherine, Luke, and Sean can take the stage as we announce which of these three fine, outstanding scholars of Polish history is the inaugural Tadeusz Kosciuszko Prize winner and heading to Poland. Again, the top overall score went to the elementary division in Krzysztof Piotrowski, but he had a bit of an advantage being from Poland. But of these three fine scholars, congratulations, the winner of the Tadeusz Kosciuszko Prize for 2022 and the overall score on the country exam goes to Sean Castellanets from Texas. Congratulations, Sean. And I had a bit of an inkling, and Sean confirmed that, Castellanets is indeed a Polish last name. So we will have a proud Polish-American patriot in the legacy of Tadeusz Kosciuszko winning the trip to Poland for 2022. Congratulations, Sean, and congratulations to Luke and Catherine as well for phenomenal scores. We're getting very close to the end of our program, so you can all back. But we have a few very important remaining awards still to present. And those are the overall International History Olympiad champions. We award the top 10. And after that, I will announce which countries made the top 10 in the medals table as the final results to be announced, and then I have just a final word or two. So this won't take more than about another 10 minutes or so. So let's move to those overall champions. Now that we have the tie break broken, we will begin with the elementary division. And in 10th place, overall, Imandeep Mataro from California. Ninth place off the basis of the tiebreak, and also second place in the elementary school division. He was doing the tiebreak when we announced it earlier for the International History of the World Championships. Congratulations, Sahil Prasad of Maryland. Eighth place off that tiebreak goes to Evan Ting of Indiana. With the flag cape, our favorite style. Seventh place goes to Lucas Xiong from the state of Oregon. Sixth place goes to Parnavdeep Singh Pundi from Canada. Fifth place goes to Sarang Chong from New Jersey. Fourth place to Henry Berger of Maryland. Third place goes to DeWitt Silber from New Jersey. take the bronze podium there. Second place goes to Gavin Sigwa from Indiana. And your overall Olympiad champion in the elementary division, congratulations, Satvik Jain of Maryland. Finishers in the elementary division. And we'll move right ahead to middle school. Thank you all and congratulations. In the middle school division, 10th place goes to Max Guo of California. Ninth place to Alan Marek of Georgia, the U.S. state. Eighth place goes to Zach Lamb of Maryland. Seventh place goes to Grady Noble of Idaho. Sixth place goes to Houghton Nepple of Virginia. Goes to Luke Ng of Singapore. Fourth place to Gil Pedrotti of Louisiana. Third place, take the bronze podium, Padraig Finan of Washington State. Second place, the Shonak Bindwale of California. And the overall champion in the middle school division, from the U.S. state of Georgia, Samanyu Ganesh.
Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
Georgia!
Congratulations to our middle school top 10.
I said, Georgia, Georgia.
In the junior varsity division, 10th place goes to Lucas O'Flanagan of Connecticut. Ninth place goes to Shivam Anamalai from California. Eighth place to Valentin LeBlanc from New York. Seventh place, also from New York, Agastya Mittal. Sixth place to Canada's Derek Lee. Fifth place to California, Benjamin Marek. Fourth place to Jaden Cho from South Korea. Third place to California, Kerry Hsu. Second place, Ethan Liu from Massachusetts. And adding a world championship in the International History Olympiad to a very full IAC trophy case, your overall champion of the JV, Aaron Parson from California.
I love you, California. You're the greatest state of all. I love you in the winter, summer, spring, and in the fall.
Congratulations, and that just leaves varsity then. Congrats to our JV top 10.
When the snow crowned golden Sierras keep their water short.
And in the varsity division, overall 10th place goes to New Jersey's Simon Emmanuel. Ninth place in the varsity to Jack Dixon from Indiana. The Hoosier State cheering section out in force. Eighth place in the varsity, Canada's Richard Chen. Seventh place to James O'Reilly of Arizona. Sixth place to Florida's Carter Copeland.
fifth place, Catherine Spusta of Alabama. Fourth place goes to the hometown champion of Ian Liu from New York. Third place to the state of Tennessee with Aditya Maduri taking honors. Second place in the varsity to Canada, Raymond Ha. And congratulations, your overall varsity champion for the 2022 International History Olympiad, Sanjeev Anand of Georgia, U.S. State.
Georgia.
Oh, he has COVID, I heard, said. Oops.
Georgia. The whole. Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
All right, congratulations, your varsity top 10. Okay, thank you, varsity students. You can take your seats. We have just a couple more messages to go. So the final medals table for the 2022 International History Olympiad. We ranked affiliations, both US states, territories, districts, and then also all the rest of the world's countries, first by gold medals, then by silver medals, then by bronze medals, not by overall sum. 10th place with 10.67 medals total, but 3.33 gold. We have fractional medals when we have mixed teams. That's the U.S. state of Florida in 10th place. 9th place. 4 medals overall, but wow, did he make them count. Congratulations, Grady Noble from the U.S. state of Idaho. 9th place. 8th place with 4 gold and 17 total, Connecticut. 7th place with 5 gold and 28 total, Canada. 6th place with 6 2/3 golds and 25 and a third overall, the U.S. state of Georgia. 5th place, 7 gold and 25 and a third overall, where you are right now, New York. 4th place, with 10 gold and 34 and 2/3 totals across the Hudson River to New Jersey. 3rd place with 10.5 gold, 14 overall, Illinois. 2nd place with 14 gold and 40 total, the highest number of medals won overall, California. 5th state that made their golds count the most, winning 19 of them, Maryland! Atop the medals table in 2022 at IHO. So, We've almost reached the end. But it wouldn't be IAC without a last minute surprise or two, wouldn't it? Yeah. I had said at the beginning of the week that I was thinking that the 2023 International History Olympiad would be in Quebec City. But with support we have received from the Polish American community, who will help you get there, IHO 2023 will be in Krakow, the beautiful historic city in Poland. And we will be working to make that as affordable as possible for everybody who thought they only had to get up to Quebec City. Ladies and gentlemen, students and competitors of all ages, I hereby declare the 2022 International History Olympiad concluded. Thank you for all support, and see you in Krakow next year.